Hydroformylation. Myself, Dr. Digna Varghese. Hydroformylation or OXO process. The oldest and largest homogeneous catalytic reaction of alkenes. For example, propylene is converted into butyraldehyde. In this reaction, alkene is converted to aldehyde. About 5 million tons of aldehyde and aldehyde derivatives are produced by this reaction annually. It was discovered by German chemist Otto Rehlen in 1938. The catalyst used for hydroformylation reaction is methyl carbonyl complex. The development of hydroformylation is one of the premier achievements of 20th century. It is important because aldehydes are easily converted into many secondary products. For example, the resulting aldehydes are hydrogenated to alcohols that are converted to detergents. Hydroformylation is also used in specialty chemicals relevant to the organic synthesis of fragrances and drugs. Specialty chemicals example is drugs molecules, also the dyes, fragrances, etc. The reaction of an alkene with carbon monoxide and hydrogen, which is catalyzed by cobalt or rhodium salts to form an aldehyde. For example, here the alkene is, to this carbon monoxide and hydrogen is added in the presence of a methyl carbonyl complex and giving aldehyde. The name of hydroformylation arises from the fact that a hydrogen atom and a formyl group is added across the carbon-carbon double bond. Type of reaction is addition reaction. Carbon monoxide and hydrogen is added to the alkene system. The net result of the process is the extension of the carbon chain by one and introduction of oxygen molecule into this. In this alkene, there is only two carbon atoms, and the product of this reaction, it gives carbon, number of carbon atoms increased by one unit. That is, in this case, the aldehyde consisting of three carbon atoms, and an introduction of oxygen atom is here. Catalyst used for hydroformylation reaction is CO2-CO8. The structure of the molecule is, in this case, there is two bridging CO group, others are terminal CO groups. In this case, the CO2-CO8 in solid state, in this case, the CO2-CO8 is in solid state. The point group of the molecule is C2V. It has another structure in solution. In this case, the cobalt-cobalt bond is here, metal-metal bond is here, and all the carbonyl, 8 carbonyls are in terminal alkene, terminal carbonyls, and the point group of the system is D3D, which is in solution. CO2-CO8 is the organometallic compound, that is, there is a carbon monoxide, carbon metal bond is here. Its name is dicobalt octacarbonyl. Dicobalt octacarbonyl is a white solid when of high purity, but more typically is an orange colored, and it is a pyrophoric solid, that is, thermally unstable. A pyrophoric substance is a substance that ignites spontaneously in air at or below 54 degrees Celsius or within 5 minutes after coming into contact with air. Pyrophoric, the word comes from the Greek word pyrophorus, fire bearing. Mechanism of hydroformylation reaction. The mechanism of co-catalyzed hydroformylation was elucidated by Richard F. Heck and David Breslow in the 1960s. CO2CO8 reacts with hydrogen to give HCOCO4, that is an 18 valence electron, which loses carbon monoxide, forming HCOCO3, a 16 valence electron species, and creating a vacant coordination site here, which acts as the active form of catalyst because it is a coordinatively unsaturated system. Alkene coordination recreates an 18 electron complex. In this step, HCOCO3, in this having a vacant coordination, and on adding alkene to this, a coordination recreates an 18 valence electron complex. Alkene coordinated complex undergoes a migratory reaction of the olefin into the COH bond, thereby creating another 16 electron complex. In this case, alkene undergoes a migratory insertion reaction of the olefin. Alkene undergoes a migratory insertion reaction in between the cobalt and hydrogen bond, that is CO3CO CH2CH2R. The vacant, and it is a 16 electron complex, the vacant coordination site is formed here, to which carbonyl group can become coordinated. Here it is a vacant coordination site. Because it's a coordinatively unsaturated species, a carbonyl ligand is added to this and form a 18 electron complex. The CO ligand of RCH2CH2COCO4, in this case the CO ligand of one of the CO ligand from this 4 carbonyl ligand group migrates to a position between the cobalt and alkyl group, that is CO3CO CO CH2CH2R. This is a critical step for the formation of an aldehyde. Reaction of hydrogen or HCO CO4- releases the aldehyde and regenerate the catalytic cobalt complex. In this case, addition of hydrogen or this compound, which releases the catalyst and the product aldehyde. Hydrogen added to RCH2CH2CHO, then the catalyst is regenerated. Importance of the reaction. Aldehyde on reduction gives alcohol. Alcohols are used as plasticizers or detergents. Selectivity of the reaction. A key consideration of hydroformylation is the normal versus isoselectivity. For example, the hydroformylation of propylene can afford two isomeric products, butyraldehyde or isobutyraldehyde. First case, hydrogen carbonyl added to the propene, a normal linear product is obtained. In the second case, hydrogen and carbonyl ligand is added to propene, an isobutyraldehyde aldehyde, isomeric isobutyraldehyde is obtained. These isomers reflect the regiochemistry of the insertion of the alkene into metal hydrogen bond. Since both products are not equally desirable, normal is more stable than iso. Much research was dedicated to the quest for a catalyst that favored the normal isomer. Hydroformylation reaction. A catalytic loop is given here. In this case, the catalyst which is added by the hydrogen forming HCOCO4. This is an 18 electron species. By the elimination of a CO group, it is converted into a 16 electron, that is the active catalyst here. By the addition of an alkene to this, giving alkene metal complex, which is undergo a migratory insertion reaction. The alkene is in between the CO and H, forming a alkyl part here. By the addition of CO, giving a 18 electron, 18 valence electron species. In this, the one of the CO is migrated in between the metal and the alkyl part. This step is very critical for the formation of an aldehyde and giving by the addition of hydrogen to this, by the addition of hydrogen to giving, or by the HCOCO4 minus complex to this, giving an aldehyde part, and a catalyst is regenerated here. Disadvantages. Cobalt carbonate catalyst used at temperature of 140 to 175 degrees Celsius and the pressure of 200 atmosphere. This is a high temperature and high pressure. The branch chain aldehydes predominate over linear molecules, which are more desirable. In the case of linear aldehyde, which is reduced to linear alcohols, which is converted to detergents, linear detergents which is more biodegradable than the detergent containing branched alcohols. A modified cobalt catalyst HCOCO3PBU thrice developed by Shell, which improved the linear to branched ratio but gives a slower reaction rate and therefore is run at higher temperature. Union Carbide developed a new catalyst HRH carbonyl PPH3 thrice catalyzes the reaction at temperature 90 to 110 degrees Celsius and 12 atmospheric pressure. It's a rhodium based catalyst. Thank you.